हॅलो एवरीवन, आय एम पूनश्री पाटील, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इन्फॉर्मेशन टेक्नॉलॉजी ऑफ AISSMS IOIT पुणे. टुडे वी हॅव टू डिस्कस दी ॲरे इन सी. सो व्हॉट इज द ॲरे? सो ॲरे इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ डेटा दॅट होल्ड द फिक्स्ड नंबर ऑफ व्हॅल्यूज ऑफ द सेम टाईप. द साईज अँड टाईप ऑफ ॲरे कॅनॉट बी चेंज आफ्टर इट डिक्लरेशन. सो ॲरे इज डिफाईंड ॲज द कलेक्शन ऑफ सिमिलर टाईप्स ऑफ डेटा आयटम्स स्टोर्ड ॲट द कॉन्टिजियस मेमरी लोकेशन. ॲरे आर द डिराइव्ड डेटा टाईप्स इन सी प्रोग्रॅमिंग लँग्वेज विच कॅन स्टोर द प्रिमिटिव्ह टाईप ऑफ डेटा सच ॲज इंटीजर, कॅरेक्टर, डबल, फ्लोट, एसेट्रा. इट ऑल्सो हॅज द कपॅबिलिटी टू स्टोर द कलेक्शन ऑफ डिराइव्ड डेटा टाईप्स सच ॲज पॉइंटर्स, स्ट्रक्चर्स, एक्सेट्रा. The array is the simplest data structure where the each data element can be randomly accessed by using the index number. So C array is beneficial if you have to store the similar elements. For example, if you want to store the marks of the student in the 6 subjects, then we do not need to define the different variables for the marks in the different subjects. Instead of that, we can define an array which can store the marks in each subject at the contiguous memory location. By using the array, we can access the element easily. Only a few lines of codes are required to access the elements of the array. So next one is the properties of the array. So each element of an array is of same data types and carries the same size, that is integer is equal to 4 bytes. So elements of the array are stored at the contiguous memory location where the first element is stored at the smallest memory location. Elements of the array can be randomly accessed since we can calculate the address of each element of the array with the given base address and size of the data elements. So here is the example. If you want to store the marks of the 100 student, you want to create an array for it, that is float marks 100. So there are these are some examples of the array can be used. Then how to declare the array in C? So syntax is the data type, then array name and array size. For example, float mark 5. Here we declare the data type as the float, array name as the marks, and the size is the 5. Okay, the elements of an array and how it is access them. So you can access the element by the indices. That is, there are the key points for some, means first one is the array is always starts from the 0, that is the first index, not from the 1. So if the size of the array is n, then to access the last m element, we have to use the n-1 element. Suppose the starting address of address is the mark 0 is the 2020, then the next address of the mark 1 will be 2024. That is, it is because the size of the float is the 4 bytes. Okay, then how to initialize the array? So it is possible to initialize the array by during the declaration. So here is the example, integer marks of 5. So we have to use the 5 subjects marks, that is 9 4 6 3 and 5, and another method for initializing arrays is the during the declaration. Okay, so here is the example, that is mark 0 to 4, and it is 9 4 6 3 5 is the given marks. So there is a, remember that working with the C arrays, suppose we declare the array of 10 elements, then let's say integer test array, that is the array name, and size is the 10, then you can use the array member from test array 0 to test array 9. If you try to access the element outside of its bound, that is means the test array of size 12, then compiler may not show any error. However, this may cause the unexpected output, that is your undefined behavior. There are three types of array are used: one dimensional array, two dimensional arrays, and multi dimensional array. In one dimensional array, the list of item can be given one variable name using only one subscript. That is the one dimensional array. The syntax for that is the type variable name and size, and examples are the float height 50, that is float is the type of the variable, then variable name is the height and size is the 50. That is only one subscript is provided, that is 50. So it is the one dimensional array. So now we can declare the array integer number of 5. So then computer reserve the 5 storage location as the size of array is the 5 is shown below, that is from 0 to 4. Then initialization of one dimensional array can be initialized at the boot time, that is the compile time and also the run time. So compile time initialization syntax is the type, then array name, then size is equal to list of the values, and the values of list are separated by using the commas. The for example, integer number 3 is equal to 0, 5, 4. Here the number is an array, then size is the 3, and we'll assign the value of to each element, that is 0, 5, and 4. So runtime initialization. In the runtime initialization, an array can also explicitly initialize at the runtime. And for example, the following C program, that is for I is equal to 0, I is less than 1, and I plus plus, and we use the scan function for scanning. So it is runtime initialization, and array count looping statement are almost compulsory. Then the looping statements are used to initialize the values of the arrays one by one using assignment operator or through the keyboard bypassing the user. Here is the one dimensional array program. Here we have to use the and name as the array, and we have to provide the data for the 5 elements. Okay, here is the output for 5 elements starting from the 0. And then next one is a two dimensional array. The simplest form of multi dimensional array is the two dimensional array, in which the list of one we in essence is the list of one dimensional array. To declare the two dimensional integer array, the size of x and y, if you write the something as follow, write type, then array name, and we have to pass the values for two. For first one is for row and column. So x defines the rows and number of rows, and y defines the number of columns. Here the initialization of the two dimensional array, where a is the name of the array, then I and j are the subscript that uniquely identify the each element in the array A. So here is the example, integer A 3, 4, that is 3 is the row and 4 are the columns. Okay, then accessing, how to access the two dimensional array element. So for example, integer value is equal to A of 2, 3 by using the array is accessed by using the subscript, that is row index, and by the column index. The above statement will take the fourth element from the third row of the array. Here is the example of two dimensional array, integer, then A is the array, and we have to use the 5 rows and 2 columns. Here is the output. Then last one is the multidimensional array. In C programming language supports multidimensional array. Multidimensional array have more than one subscript variables. Then multidimensional array is also called as the matrix. Multidimensional array, arrays. And there is a syntax for data types, array name, then declare the arrays, rows and columns. Okay, the above statement will declare an arrays of n dimensions of name, array name, where the each element of array of data type. Okay, so there we have to define the d1 to dn, that is the dimensions. And for example, here character cube 50, 60 and 30, we have to use here multidimensional array. Here is the example, we have to use here integer RCA of 50 50, B of 50 50, and sum is the 50 50. Okay, so here we have to put the multidimensional array by using the rows and column matrix. Here is the output of that program, that is the addition of two matrix, that is addition is 2, 11, 9 and 12. Thank you.